this issue came up because we needed to calculate the average cost per day in Google Ads. And while there is an average cost field, it isn't actually calculating the average cost per day. We could do some fixed math and assume that the date range would always be 30 days, but that isn't the case. We want to make sure that this date range is flexible so that we can look at different date ranges and still have an accurate cost per day. How do we calculate this? First, we're going to add a new scorecard right here. And then in the scorecard, we're going to click on the metric name and then click on add field. And then in the formula, this is what we're going to add. What the date diff function does, which is what you can see right here, is it calculates the number of days between two dates. The first date listed should be the end date and then the start date. The max function, which you see wrapped around the day dimension, returns the highest value, as in the latest date that exists in the currently selected date range. The min is the opposite. It returns the lowest value, so the earliest date that exists in the currently selected date range. And then the date diff calculates the number of days between those dates. Let's name this field number of days. Then we're going to click apply. And now we can see it's calculated 28 days. Now you can see here as well that we are actually looking at a date range that should be 30 days, but it's only going to count the number of days if you are actually running ads. In this case, this is a Google Ads data source. If you're running ads on those days, this particular client doesn't run ads on weekends. There's a weekend involved here. Therefore, it's not going to encompass the entire date range. So just double check that when you're doing this in your own calculations. Then we're going to add another scorecard for our actual math. We're going to click add a chart again, choose scorecard, drag it down here. We'll click the metric name again, click add field, and here's our new formula. You can see we're using the date diff again. This time we're using this as a divisor for the cost metric. We're going to name our metric average cost per day, click apply, and now we can see that it's calculated it out. If you do want it to show up as a currency as opposed to a number right now, open up this data type drop down here under currency and then choose the currency. For example, this would be Canadian dollars. Then click apply, and now you can see it's turned into a currency format. And that's it. If you have any questions or you're having problems getting this calculated field to work for you, make sure to leave a comment. Do you still have more questions? Check out our other videos to get more answers and leave a comment letting us know what topics you want us to cover in future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.